Hello everyone, welcome to Egra platform, and this is Ravin Jangir here, your electrical faculty. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the types of the filters which are generally used in your HVDC systems. So we will start with the what is saying that if you talk about, there are the basically two types of filters. So we are having the two types of filters that can be used. And these are two kinds of filters are, one is the passive filter and another is the active filter. So we are having the two types of the filters. One is the passive filter, another is the active filter. So if we talk about the passive filter, so we are having the passive filter. It is a kind of the tuned filter and another is the damped filter. So what happens if we use a tuned filter, then it is having the high Q. And what is Q? Q is your called quality factor. Quality factor. Or it is also called sometimes selectivity factor. So these are the quality factor, Q factor. So it is having the high quality factor. If we talk about the resonance circuit, we are having the omega L by R and 1 upon omega CR. So in the damped filter, if you talk about the second point that is listed here, second point is your damped filters, and damped filters is your low coil, having low Q coil. Now, so if we talk about the passive filters are generally used in HVDC projects from beginning till now. It is going to say that from the starting, we are generally using these tuned, or you can say the passive filters, or in that passive filters we are using till now. Okay. Now, so if we talk about the tuned filters, in passive filters, we are having the tuned filters, and that tuned filters are used to filter out the individual harmonics. Both the characteristics, either it will filter out the harmonics, kind of the characteristic harmonics and the non-characteristic harmonics. So it is kind of the individual harmonic filtration. So tuned filters is what it is doing. It is just filtering out the individual harmonics. It is kind of the harmonics, maybe kind of the your characteristics and non-characteristics. What are the characteristic harmonics? If it is followed NP plus minus one relation, then it is called your characteristic harmonics. If you talk about the non-characteristic harmonics, that relation, if it is not followed by any harmonics, then it is called non-characteristic harmonics. Now, if we let us consider the 12 pulse converter, let us consider we have taken the 12 pulse converter, then in that, the whatever the tuned filters are used are generally used to filter out, okay, generally used to filter out the 11th, 13th harmonics in addition to the third harmonic. It is, the point is saying, let us suppose we have taken the 12 pulse converter. So in that case, it is filtering out the third harmonics. Along with that, it is also filtering out the 11th harmonic and 13th harmonic in addition to that. So this is all about the 12 pulse converter. Now, the requirement of the AC and the DC filter with overhead DC lines adds to the cost of converter. This point is actually going to say that it is totally depend on the costing of the converter. If the requirement of the AC and the DC filter with the overhead DC lines, in overhead DC lines, let us suppose we are using, as per our requirement, we are using the AC filters, DC filters, then this will also add the costing of the converter. Okay. Now, however, in case of the AC filters, the passive filters act as a source of the reactive power requirement for the line commutated converter, that is the LCC with the thyristor wall. It is saying that although the cost is increased, no problem. But when we are using the AC filters, then the passive filter will act as a source of reactive power requirement. Because if we are using that filter, that kind of filter, it is also fulfill the requirement of the your reactive power, because sometimes the requirement is of the your reactive power is also necessary, injection and drawing of the reactive power. And for it is a line commutated converters and with the thyristor walls, So it is also filtering out, and along with that, it is also providing the suitable reactive power compensation. Now, so if we talk about this point, this is saying, if let us suppose we have used the DC filters, and these DC filters are generally used for minimizing the telephonic interference in the wireline communication circuits. So this point is going to say that if we are, let us suppose we have used the DC filters, so it will filter out the DC harmonics, along with that also minimize the telephonic interference that is in the wireline communication circuits. So it is these are used for the two purposes, as in the AC filters also, as in the DC filters also. So due to the no interference, if there is, let us suppose we have used this type of filters, so there will be no interference, as we have discussed in the above points, then the cost can be reduced, then the cost can be reduced significantly. So let us suppose we have taken the overhead lines, then the interference from the DC harmonics can be critical, and active filters in the series with the passive filters are suggested. This point is going to say that, let us suppose we have taken the overhead lines consideration. So what will happen? The interference from the DC harmonics can be critical. It is going to say that in the overhead lines, if we are using the DC filter, there may be interference, there may be a causes of interference. So if there is a chances of interference, that is actually a critical condition. That's why what is suggested, the suggestion is given that the active filters in series with the passive filters are suggested, so that this harmonious condition cannot be arise again. So I hope you have understood all the points related with this topic. So Tata, bye bye, and thank you.